Well, guys, what you're seeing right now may just be the most schema Hawardi caterpillars you may ever see in a video in your life. They're extremely beautiful and awesome. Just look at their metallic blue tubercules. And their hairs and coloration is simply an incredible species. Really, I'm amazed. I'm also amazed by how well they are doing. I've been told it's a very difficult species to breed and that not many people have managed to do it. But I haven't lost a single one since I received them. A second instar larva, think about that. That's a 100% success rate, wow. And I cannot wait to see the adults because these moths, they are just incredible. They are even more pretty than their larva. I really hope to do a video on them when their life cycle is completed. Just look at it, it's magnificent. They're also huge for what are caterpillars of tiger moth. I mean, just put my hand in here. Of course, I breed a lot of larger species than this, but for one from this family, it's rather big. You don't often see tiger moths of this size. And it's just incredible, really. Wow, I'm so amazed. Of course, I don't keep them in this container, but in a much larger container. But currently I'm cleaning them and only putting the caterpillars here for a very short amount of time, just enough to film them. This is where I actually rear them in. Their favorite food is dandelion, Taxaricum. And between the layers of dandelion, there's toilet paper. See, actually it's paper towel, not toilet paper. But I meant what I'm also putting rolls, toilet rolls of paper, toilet paper in here. And they like to hide in this. And they actually like to spin cocoons in this because Arctidae tiger moths, they like to spin cocoons in a safe place. There are some twigs in there, they don't really need them. They are willow, salix twigs, but they will not eat the willow. It's just for them to walk on. Dandelion. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place them in here, just like this. Maybe I'll take the opportunity to count some of them. See, there's number one. There you go, number one. So let's take number two. There you go, number two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. As you can see, they're quickly hiding because the caterpillars are nocturnal and they don't like bright light. Usually they hide during the day and they only come out at night. So that's why I give them places to hide, like these toilet rolls. As you can see, they're disappearing quick. But when I turn off the lights, they will come back to feed. So we were at seven, so there's number eight. Almost there. Nine. 10, 11, 12, 13, we are 13 now, so there we are. These are two of them, they're number 14 and 15, so let's go, 14 and 15, oops, well, there's two left. They are 16 and 17, and that confirms my suspicions, because when I just got them in the mail, they were mailed to me from a contact in America. And when I got them, I received them as 17 tiny caterpillars. And it's amazing that 17 caterpillars are still alive today, because I breed a lot of moths and butterflies every year, but it's normal for a few of them to die. That's just what insects are like. It's a selective progress and only usually the strongest ones will make it. So a success rate of 100% is incredible from tiny caterpillar to adult. Some of them are hiding here on the toilet rolls. And wow, it's just, I can't think, I'm so happy with them. I've been wanting to breed this species for years. I mean, they're just incredible. Also very hard to get because they're rare. Thanks for watching. Please keep viewing my YouTube because I'll film the adults when they emerge.